First of all, I welcome all the dignitaries came from Thailand to the Scientific Academy, it is the National Academy of Letters India. We have a very close relation with Thailand, particularly we have started even our cultural exchange program with Thailand. In 2013, we sent an Indian writers delegation to Thailand, and last year we have received a delegation from Thailand, which is the Department of Art and Conservation. And in between, sometimes these Thailand writers and scholars, they visit to India. Whenever they come here, they come to the Sahitya Academy also. And I'm also happy to inform you that in 2013, we gave the very prestigious fellowship, Ananda Kumar Swami Fellowship, to Dr. Sopana Sri Champa. She from Bangkok. We gave the fellowship. She was here for almost 1 month and gave the lectures, and she was the guest in our main important functions in 2013. Because why I'm telling you the close relation, in Thailand, our mother language Sanskrit is equally important in our country. So we are very close to each other, and one of our very senior writer and scholar, Professor Satyavrata Shastri, is a guide to your princess here, in fact. Mm-hmm. And she gave India two, 3 years back to give an award to him in the Indian Parliament. So this is the close relation what we have. And before we proceed further to introduce ourselves, I'll just briefly introduce our institution. I think you are visiting, that is also one of the main purpose to visit the academy. This institution, it was instituted on 12th March 1954 by the Government of India, and it is fully funded by the government. We have branches in Calcutta, Bombay, Bangalore, and also a small branch in Chennai, and one special branch for the northeastern sector, that is in Imphal and Agartala, we have branches. And our academy works under the guidance, and from time to time the policy makers are a committee called the General Council and also Executive Board. This General Council is 99 members representing from various state governments. In India we have at present 36 states and union territories, altogether 36 we have. 36 state government representatives will be there, and the Government of India representatives, university representatives, and the writers community representatives. But all of them are writers and scholars, not in the capacity of government officials. Even government nominee, the main criteria is they have to be either writer or a scholar in the field of literature. That is our main criteria to become our member. Whenever we reconstitute our General Council, we request the government to nominate only such people, those who are in the field of literature and language. So our 99 members are all writers and scholars, whether they are representative of writers community, or whether they are representative of universities, or whether they are representative of state government. But they are all writers and scholars. So we, Sahitya Academy, we call it is a writer's home, it is. India's writer's home. And at present we are working, we promote 24 Indian languages. 24. Government of India recognizes 22. We have recognized 25. But Sahitya Academy recognized long ago these two languages. So whatever we work, either we organize programs or we publish books, whether we give the awards and honors, we will do in 24 languages. We treat all the languages, whether it is a small language or a big language like English or Hindi, we treat all of them as an equal, like a family members. This is what we do. And Sahitya Academy gives 4 different kind of awards every year. One is Sahitya Academy Award. So in Indian rupees it is 1 lakh, that means nearly $1,600. And all 24 language writers will get, that means 24 awards. And we have one more award called Translation Prize, that is best translation from one language to one language. because in India translation activities main, because every Indian is a bilingual or if not a tri or four, because suppose I know four languages thoroughly, I can understand another half dozen languages. But so in India translation activities much compared to any other country in the world, because we deal with so many hundreds of languages, translation activity is the main important activity in India. So that is why Sahitya Academy promoting translation activity. Every year we give translation award in each language, that is also again in 24 languages, and that is nearly $800 per each award into 24. From one Indian language to another Indian language, but in 10, this is the important area where we should concentrate. So we started this children award, the writers who write for the children. Again, that is also $800 each language, 24 awards. And we have one more award, that is young writer award, up to the age of 35 years, below 35. For the best work, whatever he writes, a story collection, or a poetry collection, or a novel, whatever, any, all genres we cover. That is also about $800. In Indian rupees, it is 50,000. Whenever I say $800 means 50,000, $1,600 means 1 lakh. Again, to 24 languages, 24 young writer award, 24 children award, 24 translation awards, 24 main creative writing awards. So altogether we give 96 awards every year, and in addition to this, every year we give 4 awards to the unrecognized languages of India, because India has nearly 1000 languages, more than even. In the, if you go to Northeast, every village gets changed the language, every village or every if you cross 10 kilometers, you will get a language will be changed. In the Northeastern India itself, you have a more than 400 languages there itself we have. So we want to preserve and promote and to look after those, the writers and scholars who are working on those unrecognized languages. Every year we promote 4 languages. So again we give $1,600 for the writer, and every year we give 4 awards. So this 96 and 4, 100 awards every year we give. And to decide this 100 awards, nearly 2,450 writers and scholars are involved in the award deciding process. This many writers are involved in the, it is a year long process. For every award there is a different kind of process. You will have everything in our website also, whenever you have free time you can go through it. But nearly 2,450 Indian writers and scholars are involved in deciding these 100 awards. This is how our award process is. And in addition to that, nearly 500 to 5, what the figure what I am saying, that is the last year figure. 550 books we have published last year, this institution, in 24 languages. That means in every 16 hours we have published one book, that is the average we can take out. And also we have organized nearly 450 literary activities, different programs, a kind of symposium or a seminar of national, regional level, or a translation workshop, or a literary forums, or a symposia, or any poetry readings, poetry festivals, Shastri festivals, this kind of various literary activities in academy platforms, and sometimes in the university campuses, wherever this literary gathering can take place. So we organized nearly 450 programs last year. That means nearly, if you take out the average, in every 19 hours we organized one program. That is the average of our last year activity. This is how we do the program and the publication. And our books also sells very well. We organize book exhibitions, and also we participate in the book fairs, national book fairs, international book fairs. And last year we have organized nearly 180 book exhibitions throughout the country. And we also earn some money. That is, last year our sale was $300,000 books we have sold last year. And we have a very good library. If you have some time after this interaction, you can visit our library at downstairs. We have a very good collection, 180,000 book collection we have in, again, more than 24 languages that we can say. Other than 24 also we have there. And we have near about 10,500 membership in our library. So every day 100 to 125 members visit, and they take the books, and sometimes they do the research work here. Because our library is India's best literary research library we have here. We have a cultural exchange program with various countries. Example I mentioned just now with Thailand. China is one of the very active cultural exchange we have with China, and Malaysia, many other countries we have a cultural exchange. And also we participate in various international book fairs, like Frankfurt Book Fair, Sharjah International Book Fair. Wherever India is a guest country, there also we visit very regularly. These are the short introductions I gave about our institution, and also we have placed on the table academies some kind of brochure. You can go through it. If you have any further details, you can ask me, or you can see our website. This is how I think is enough to worry you about our institution. With this, I once again I welcome all the dignitaries came from Thailand, and particularly Professor Dr. Pakpong Phan, who is the president of the Royal Society of Thailand. We have with us my colleagues, they will introduce. I think we can introduce one after one. Okay. That will be better, I think. Let us start with the president.
Well, Dr. Srinivasarao, the secretary of the Sahitya Academy, or in English, National Academy of Letters, Ministry of Culture, Government of India. We are very impressed with what you have informed us, and I think that your organization is very well described in this brochure. It is, if you don't mind me repeating, it is an organization of the writers, for the writers, and shaped by the writers. In short, it's a home of writers. And well, I'm, as for ourselves, the Royal Society of Thailand, I have presented to you our brochure, as well as the bio data of our delegation in the blue, in the blue cover, each and every one of us. In short, today our delegation comprises of 16 fellows and associates of the three academies, namely Academy of Moral and Political Science, Academy of Science, and Academy of Arts. And then we have also 9 government officers who come here, who work full time to help us organize our activities. Our main activities are many. Our mission is, one of them is to help promote and maintain the quality of Thai language. And then another one is to translate the foreign, the technical terms in foreign language into Thai language. And another one which is equally important is to strengthen the relationship with foreign organizations of similar nature. And Sahitya Academy is one of them that we have in mind to visit and further strengthen our relationship. And this time, at this time, if you don't mind, I would like to ask each and every one of us to briefly introduce themselves. Let me start with the right-hand side, please. Left-hand side.
Thank you, President. My name is Thupsak Chamlongner. I'm the chairman of Science Division of Royal Society. My special field is chemical engineer. Work on petrochemical. Many projects that in petrochemical.
Good afternoon. My name is Professor Zizuran Kuntak, but the spelling will be longer, like Kuntak here, but the entire known as Kuntak. And I am in the Academy of Arts, doing mainly the comparative literature, but I also help with the history of Asia also. Happy of moral and political sciences.
Good afternoon. I'm Song Sing Chan Long San, a fellow in linguistics. And by listening to the description of the institution, I quickly glanced through this catalog. I'm quite impressed. I can even single out one important publication. That's the 14 volume of Ashtangayi and Bhagavad Gita. Because I happened to study Sanskrit as a child, I even remember some of the sutra, Shiva Sutra, classification of consonants in Sanskrit. So I'm very pleased to know that this publication, this big series has come out. And also one more question, I was wondering if you have any kind of relationship with, say, the Clay Sanskrit Library, because at the start of the this important project has been taken over by some Indian millionaire in this country. Do you have any idea about this?
Okay. I'm Gitanjali Chatterjee. I work in the Science Academy and I look after the English translation publications and programs. And I welcome you all to it.
Good afternoon. My name is Darika. I accompany my husband back to Goa.
Mr. Chairman, I am Pankit Sirikwanagut. I'm an associate fellow of the Academy of Moral and Political Science and our Lawyer Academy Society. And I am a former dean of Faculty of Psychology from Jadavagon University. It's nice to know you. Thank you.
My name is Professor Lira Jintong, Academy of Art.
My name is Jitananda Moga, fellow in the Academy of Arts, specializing in French language and literature.
Thank you.
My name is Sudhakar Kamchangong, Professor Emeritus in Polymer Engineering. I have been published more than 150 technical papers, so I realize how important and how difficult to be a good writer. I also taught project proposal and scientific writing, so this is really good chance to learn how to better develop the student to be a good writer. Thank you.
Associate Fellow in the Academies of Art. I'm specialized in Thai literature.
Pilot Thong Kham Sut, performing Thai classical dance, fine art department.
Namaskar, I am Dr. Devendra Kumar Deves, working with Science Academy as officer on a special duty and light in Hindi, especially in the field of children literature and comparative literature. Thanks.
Good afternoon, all of you. My name is Ajay Kumar Sharma. I am working with Science Academy as assistant editor Hindi. I know after Hindi publication and thank you.
I am Ms. Subhanya Shomchinda, Secretary of the Office of the Loyal Society of China. Thank you.
Good afternoon. I am Dr. Khurshid Alam, working with Science Academy, fiction writer in Urdu and Hindi, and translator vice versa.